Dressed up is a noisy place. A car goes off, a dog starts barking, another car hit another car. It's a real nice area, but a lot of interruptions. Anyway, that's what I'm going to do, is drive all the way from Niagara, which I'm already on the way, and past Cleveland, through Chicago, and into Sioux City, Iowa. And then from there, spend the night at an RV. I already called them, so it's all set up. So all told, I think that this is my longest drive. It'll be a little under 1,600 miles. But when you have a motorhome, when you have an RV, that's all it takes. That's all you need. You got your own home on wheels. So you can stop any place and drive as long as you want. Okay, thanks for watching. I'll make sure that these videos are posted and you can watch them. Thank you. Okay, you're looking at a tornado that's starting to brew right now. I see it and we're running from it. There's lightning inside and we're going down. I don't know, we gotta get out of here. It's coming at us. Hello there, this is Alex. This video is number 2 of 4 on the way home from 2015, which I had been meaning to edit but was unable until this week. Returning to California, the USA trip, lower states and the East Coast, and some of the northern states we visited. I was on the 90 West heading to the next stop to visit, which was Rapid City. The campground reservations were set for the next 3 days. During our stay, we were to visit Mount Rushmore and also drive along a 17-mile tour of the Black Hills, which would bring us back to our campsite. At this time, we had already visited Niagara Falls and had been at the Falls campground for 3 days. From Niagara, we headed south through New York State and through Ohio past Chicago, Illinois. The freeways through Chicago took us to the Chicago Stadium where the Cubs played. Continuing west on the 90 freeway, we almost reached Rapid City in South Dakota when we received a phone call that turned out to be an emergency. So we had no choice but to cancel the rest of the tour of the western states in the US. Instead of continuing I-90 west and then going around Yellowstone Park, I thought that it might be quicker if I doubled back on the I-90 and take the I-29 south to Omaha, Nebraska, to the I-80 west, and then the I-15 south to California. But when I got on the I-80 west, I decided to take the 76 connecting to the 70, which would cut across and connect to the I-15 south above Las Vegas. It sounded so good, it looked good, but I just didn't take the time to investigate it. It was not good. The 76 and 70 took me through the Colorado Rocky Mountains, through Aspen, Colorado, and then finally we stopped at Grand Junction, Colorado. Colorado and Utah has beautiful country, with the scenery just perfect. From the time I began coming down from the Rocky Mountains, I thought I would be home free getting to the bottom of the mountains. But driving a few miles level, I would then start going down again, which seemed like it would never end. It just kept coming down, and I mean, these are big freeways and everybody's traveling at 70 miles an hour, trucks, cars, motorhomes, and it rains a lot, it was snowing. I mean, we ran into all kinds of weather. Beautiful country though. The scenery is just perfect. Next year, Or maybe this year, I might visit Colorado and Utah again and stay a while this time around. Anyway, we continued on the 70, which then took me through the Utah Canyons, Moab, and all this time dropping from 11,000 feet, I think that's how high Aspen is, to Las Vegas sea level. When I reached the 15 south, I thought Las Vegas was right there, but it wasn't. I still had to drive a long ways to get to Las Vegas, and as I passed Las Vegas, I could see all the casinos, and oh, that was part of the plan, to stop there and stay there 3-4 days. But we couldn't because we had this emergency that we had to return home. So this video is only a small part of driving through Colorado. You know, the country's just beautiful. This video is one of four, because what I did once we got the call to return to California, what I did is I just left the cameras running, and as the cameras ran, I just saved all the video. And now that I'm starting to, you know, travel again, I'm starting to pick up or catch up on the videos that I hadn't done. So I'll be posting them. I think I've already posted one or two up there, but I think what I'll do is I'll post all these, all four of them at the same time, and then start on this year's videos. I hope you enjoy it, and thanks for watching them. I appreciate it. Thank you very much. Oh, this is Alex again. You know this truck that you see on the video right here? He came onto the freeway like a bat, like going crazy. And this guy would not, he would just slow down and go fast. He would slow down and go fast. I just couldn't get away from him. But finally I pulled off the freeway and I got rid of him. This guy's a crazy driver. Anyway, what I wanted to mention is that Niagara Falls, we went on the American side, and it was really a fantastic tour. If you ever get to see the falls, that's number one. You should go there and take a tour bus. Okay, thank you for listening.
miles. Enter the tunnel.